equipment. Okay. So, Nimba. The Nimba.
Yes. It is me. The man.
The eldritch being that is you.
The eldritch being that is me, this time in the form of an Eladrin.
Alright.
As well, opposed to a frog.
I will start this how I've started every session zero so far, and describe the city for you.
Alright.
So, welcome to my domain, to Kyodi. Kyodi is a massive, sprawling city of technological and magical wonder, spanning from machines to spells, name it. With their heavy influence from the Feywild and the bits and pieces you can pick out throughout the city, the magic is there.
Indeed.
I can't wait for someone to cast the tech magic.
Well, I do think it's not on my list out of fear. I don't want to be blind immediately.
But it is divided into many, many districts, for corporations, for different standards of living, shopping, the Central Plaza, the Imperial Palace itself. So, where we find you is, well, actually, we don't technically find you in the city, as you wake up for the day in your bunking. Is that what we want to call it, to keep it nonchalant?
I guess, technically.
Alright.
I mean, it is what it is, but it is technically bunking, for the most part.
Would you like to describe what your room in this magnificent mansion looks like?
Well, Irafis is both, it, at points, is form over function, and at other points is function over form. So it is very much kind of a hodgepodge of that.
Mm-hmm.
He has decorations around. He keeps his swords, he keeps his current weapon especially up on, like, pretty much a pedestal when it comes to it. But other than that, it is surprisingly simple, so that he doesn't have any distractions when he is researching new spells or focusing in on trying to do stuff. There's a training dummy in there, though, that he makes sure to repair every single time he nearly destroys it. Which, I mean, it's fairly easy to do when you start slapping it with, when you start slapping something made out of, like, straw and wood out of, with force damage.
Yeah. Yeah, that'll do it. Hold on, I need to save an image real quick that I completely forgot about. Okay. Alright. So, you wake up in your room in your magnificent mansion. You describe to those listening, the Weave don't have barracks or dorm rooms or whatever the hell you want to call it in there.
We are all shoved into a magnificent mansion to sleep in.
The way
all
it
of us
works
together.
Is there's just a hallway lined with doors that each member has keys to certain doors, and a group of them share a magnificent mansion together. Without the key, the door is open to a brick
wall.
But if you have the key, you may enter your home. They reserve their rooms for diving coffins, seers, gatherings, places for the actual higher members of the Weave, and the larger areas are reserved for the Weave Master himself.
Granted, Irafis does have his own mansion that he can cast up, but he usually only does it when he's, like, on extended missions.
Mm-hmm.
You know, can't. Slot. Yeah, it's a save spell slot when I'm here.
Hey,
but hey,
that's five more casts of shield.
That is five more casts. No, Magnus' mansion's like eight, isn't it? Is a it, lot more cast.
Am I completely
shield.
Wrong?
I can check. It's on my list.
I have to remedy this.
It's seven. It's seven more casts of shield.
Oh, it's seven more casts of shield. It's a whole cast and a half of the funny spell.
Exactly.
And five and seven casts of the other spell.
It's seven casts of the unspoken one.
Yeah. And the almost four casts of the big suck.
The bad suck, I hope you mean.
Yep.
It's not the big suck, it's the bad suck. The big suck is if you cast at ninth.
Okay. Alright, but you would know that today is a relatively big day. Every once in a while, the Weave will hold a set of days where they will send all of their newer, all of their lower members in a dive into the Weave to see who can do what, prospects to move up from Grunt to Weaver, and so on and so forth. And also just to see who has new powers they can utilize. But today is one of those days, and it is a day you will be taking your dive.
So what am I classified as currently? Like a grunt in terms
you're
of...
just a grunt.
Fair. Well...
You were just a basic boy.
Irafis would stretch a bit. God, fuck. I was... And here I was actually having a good dream. But... Either way, time to slap the day on the ass and make it mine. As he gets up, grabs a sword, spins it a bit, ignites it to make sure that it's working. Which to describe to the thing, the sword will ignite into a bright set of golden runes that basically make up the simulacrum of a blade, and then he will turn it back off. Okay, you're working fine. Not missing any shit, am I? Book. Sword. Emergency underwear. I'm good. I think.
Don't forget the brand.
I'll be good.
You stored under your left shoe for later.
Right. Always have contingencies. Never trust the Weave. That thing, if everything I've heard is right, that thing's gonna fuck me up. So,
all right.
After making sure that he has all of his stuff gathered up, he will exit his room.
All right. You exit your room into, as I mentioned earlier, this hallway of just doors to nothing. You exit. You don't see many members around at the moment because everyone has made their way to the diving halls to either dive they themselves or witness the diving of the others.
Oh fuck, am I late? Well, no time like the present, then. As he has the mana to spare, he'll slap himself with a kinetic jaunt just to make sure that he gets there, that he gets there in time.
Alrighty. Oh god, I'm gonna burn. Sorry. Okay,
it's fine.
You sprint your way through the halls to one of the near diving rooms. And we walk into this diving room and we just see a couple. There's probably about 18 large Vizstone coffins spread out throughout this room. Each one filled with their own batches of water and ice and charged by devices attached to group sections of two of them to energize the coffins to aid in the sealing and cooling of the coffin, as diving into the Weave has a toll. I'm simultaneously looking at the bridge. But You get in there. You're not necessarily late. They just started the first dives.
Well, I mean, better to be just at the start than nearly at the end, so.
Mm-hmm. All right. But as I said, you get there as they've started the first handful of dives. What is it you would like to do?
Are there still, like, dive tanks open and stuff like that, or are they mostly all sealed currently?
Currently, they are all sealed.
Well, Irafis will just say to himself, well, fuck, and here I was hoping I'd get first jump. And I can wait a little bit, as he will find a space to, sit and check over his spell book while waiting for people to start coming out.
All right. You sit and watch for a little while. Most of the dives, at least on the surface as in what you're observing, don't seem to take too terribly long. They're, you know, 10 to 20 minutes for the most part. They make it a way down and eventually come back up. The coffins are open and they're escorted out. Nothing really special happens. There are a couple that take a bit longer and then come up looking better than the others. Like they didn't, it wasn't as much of a toll on them. They are taken away by other weavers of the group, the next rank. Can you make me a perception check, please?
Alright. 14.
Okay. As you're watching these weavers escort these other members around, you're looking around, and you see two figures that catch your attention. The first is this slender half-elven man. I don't have an image for this one, but this slender half-elven man with a flowing red cloak and a purple suit underneath, a runic necklace adorning him, and gauntlets on his arms. Someone you would recognize as one of the Red Hand.
Oh, fuck. Do I have any idea which one it is?
Yes, you would. This one's title will be known as the Sorcerer Supreme.
Oh, fucking hell. That certainly doesn't seem normal. I had a Red Hand here for this.
And there's another strange figure on next to him. You see a taller satyr with green hair, flowers throughout it, a red dress, and a central glowing red crystal on her chest. And I do have an image for this one.
Well, fuck. Sorcerer Supreme's here and someone I don't know is here. Great. Great.
She seems to be existing near the sorcerer. As he is overviewing the dives to see if anything truly interesting happens. What's up?
Irafis will just look at them for a while and just think to himself, huh. I understand the need to keep to like make sure nothing bad happens, but I didn't, and I know that we will most likely kick my ass, but I didn't expect But I didn't expect full-on Red Hand to show up for all this shit.
Alright.
This is gonna be fun.
As this first batch of dives nears its end, there's one member that stays down for an extremely long time. And many people take notice of this. You see the sorcerer himself approach the coffin he's in. As the member is sitting there, he looks rough. He looks like it has been a very big toll on him to get to wherever he currently is. You watch as the water around this man begins to glow a deep, deep red.
That doesn't look fucking good.
Before it glows at an intensity you can't even look at.
Shit, and here I was making sure that I didn't go blind.
When light
fades, I need my eyes.
When light fades, all that's left is a lifeless body floating in the surface. I feel like I cut out for a lot of that.
No, you were there for just enough.
Okay. My Discord was looking weird.
Fucking hell. And here, I was expecting this would be easy. Should have known that death was normal. Death always seems to be common where I end up. Fuck me, I guess.
Hear the sorcerer sigh and motion and have him removed from the coffin. Taken to God knows where. And we begin the next set of dive. Would you like to be part of this set?
Yeah, Irafis will walk up and take a spot in the next set. He's willing.
Okay.
Hell, he'll even say, give me the one the man died in. I'm willing to, I want to see if I can get as far as him.
The weaver currently manning the coffin just goes, whatever floats your boat, man, I guess. Go ahead and get in.
And I will.
Alright.
Alright, got some magic. You give me fucking luck today.
You sink into the water. It is ice cold. You are freezing. As the lid is moved on top, sealing the coffin. I should also mention, you're closer to the Sorcerer Supreme and the Satyr figure you saw now. You are one of the closer coffins to them. But you watch as the lid is sealed, and you lay back in the water for a minute. And for a minute, it's the question of, am I going to drown? Is this it? And you blink, and you are no longer in the coffin. You are now staring out at a vast, endless blue expanse. You can see
so this is it, huh?
Other figures entering around you.
Didn't expect the weave to be so blue.
You see many of them begin their descents. But as you stop and look around, you turn in the direction of the two you saw. You see two things. First thing you see is where one of the figures standing. You don't know which. There was a massive indention in the weave. A very large, I don't know if I want to call it sinkhole, but disturbance in the surface. The other one's more interesting. Instead of the massive disturbance that spreads out, there is a singular, probably about 5-foot diameter hole that just plummets down and down and down. And from inside it, you see a faint red glow.
Now that definitely doesn't fucking look right.
What do you do?
Part of Irafis is tempted to see what if he could possibly use their odd disturbances in the weave to kind of force him deeper. But for now, he isn't wanting to just use whatever power other people have to push him farther. He's going to see how far he can go himself before relying on anything like that. He's going to start going straight down as fast as he can.
All right. So, your intelligence modifier is 5, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yep.
Okay. You have a full swim speed in the weave, if that's what we want to call it. A full weave speed. Equal to your walking speed.
All right.
Oh god. Alright. You begin to descend, assumably just sinking at your normal speed. You sink. You see other members ahead of you. A couple of them blink out. As you're sinking, there's a warm sensation that begins to build at the base of your skull. But you keep sinking.
I'm going farther.
It doesn't hurt, but it's not comfortable.
I don't care if it ain't comfortable. If this is a way that I can prove that I'm stronger than I was then so fucking be it. I'm going farther.
And you can continue to descend. As you keep going, the pain does slowly build. And you begin to see creatures of seemingly pure arcane energy. At this point, none of them seem to be messing with any of the continuing members. But it's definitely a possibility.
I can see what these creatures look like, right?
For the most part.
Okay, I'm gonna make mental notes of that in my head.
A lot of the ones
what
you're seeing at the moment
creatures are.
Look very similar to just normal marine creatures. At the moment. Just made of pure magic.
Weave fish, got it.
Yes. They're sitting in a fast food restaurant glowing orange.
Beautiful.
As you continue to descend, the creatures start to grow in size. And you stop seeing less of the more humble-looking aquatic life, if that's what we would like to call it.
Mm-hmm.
And start seeing more aggressive. Massive. Well, not massive, but large octopi. These barracuda-like fish. You look below you and the handful of members that are still going, you see some of them dealing with these monsters. Some of them are fighting them off. You see one member get hooked by one of these barracudas and begin to be dragged back up towards the surface. You see two members at odds against one of the octopi swimming around you.
So, in terms of what I have, it's mostly just myself and myself. No sword?
Yourself and whatever spells you have in your spellbook.
I see.
Prepared or no?
I see the people, I see the two of them over there dealing with it. How does that fight look currently?
A lot of it, you see, them attempting to move faster. You see them attempting to shield themselves. Most of them are not attempting to damage these creatures. And you don't know why.
Well, with at least my brain, I'm like, well, these things are fucking magic. I have a good feeling that magic probably doesn't barely even affect them.
I will note, in terms of affecting as a whole, the shields, some of the shielding is proving effective. Blocking the hits from coming.
Yeah, it at least just with Irafis's mind, he's like, okay. Where I'm, if this is the weave, and I'm pretty sure it fucking is, then if these things are basically built of pure magic, I doubt that like spells to attack them will work as well. That's just like his thought process. Just like, these things are made of magic, they probably have a way to like absorb magic if it hits them and stuff like that. But he'll just see that people are going farther and is just like, okay. Shielding seems to work. I could probably use some teleporting to get even further. And he will immediately start continuing down.
Alright. The member that was taken by the fish does not return down. And the two fighting the octopi do not continue.
Sucks to be them, but I need to go as far
There's
as I can.
Maybe.
Sorry.
Four of you left. As you continue down. Is there anything you wish to do before we continue?
He'll look at the ones beside him and just kind of think to himself, damn it, here I was hoping that there'd be at least a few more. Well, sucks to be those guys that got dragged out, but I can't stop to help you right now.
Right. You progress downward. And the creatures continue to grow. And before you know it, you look down and you see one of these fish heading towards you. Larger, with hook-like fins. Shooting at an admirable speed towards you.
Okay, bitch, I guess this is how we're gonna play then. He'll think to himself, well, this is the weave. I don't know if magic will help, but it's better than nothing. As, I will cast Mirror Image on myself.
Okay. You watch as... If I'm not mistaken, is it three duplicates you get?
Yep, three copies.
Okay. You watch as three motes of... your Arcana appear encircling you.
This is a bit weird. This spell doesn't work like this. Oh, fuck. I didn't plan for spells working weird.
The fish does continue towards you.
Okay, you're
maybe 60 feet.
Okay, you're a fist, thank you. Irafis will think for a moment. And smile a bit. Well, I mean, there's always the fun shit. but I doubt that I can really dance down here. But I mean, if it wants to, if it's coming for me, why not face it head on? As he will, this turn, cast haste on himself.
Okay.
And I am going to sink down at my hasted speed. And as it comes up to, like, attack me, to possibly attack me, I'm going to try and use my faster, like, more hasted speed to attempt to dodge it so I can go further down even faster so I can outrun it.
Okay. It will still cross you as you head down.
Mm-hmm.
And it is going to attempt to grab.
Alright.
But you have an increased AC and 3 mirror images, so we shall see. Would a 17 hit you?
Well, it's with that. Well, you still have to roll the d20 to see if the mirror, see if it attacks the mirror image.
Don't you roll to hit and then you roll the mirror image?
Each time a creature targets you with an attack, roll a d20 to determine whether the attack targets you or a duplicate.
Oh, okay. I thought it was the attack roll first. Okay, I'll roll it. That is a 2.
I have to roll it. Never mind. I'm an idiot.
Okay.
I have to roll the d20.
Go ahead and roll your d20. You need a 6 or higher for it to hit
9.
A duplicate. Okay, so it hits a duplicate.
Mm-hmm. It would have hit the duplicate. It would have hit me either way because duplicates are only have an AC of 10 plus dex, but I have shields. So if it still hit me.
Yeah.
But yeah, it will lunge for me as one of the motes blades, like, all right. Let's see if it still works the same. As he will just kind of push it into its direction to try and distract it and make it look like that's the real one. As he will try and as Irafis will try and go past it to its side.
All right. The fish grabs the mirror image. In which case, I mean, grabs literally nothing. And you fly past it.
I am using my hasted action to dash.
If you're putting everything you can into dashing, you do outspeed this fish.
Yeah, I'm like, this thing's gonna try and chase me. I'm using everything I've got to outspeed this fuck.
You are outrunning this, and it eventually gives up on its chase, knowing it's not going to grab.
Does it look like I'm in a safe area after it gives up? At least there isn't anything charging me directly yet.
You don't notice any of that. You do begin to notice currents in the world. Flowing currents of different types of magic. You see smaller flows that after looking at it for a second, looks like the power grid of Kyodi. You see changes in currents as different magical acts are performed throughout the city. You look around and you still see that red sinkhole plunging through the weed, currents, disrupting the creatures, disrupting the flow of some of the magic in the area. As it continues down.
I'm going to move so that I am closer to the flow. I'm not going to just like try and shove myself in it, but I'm going to try and follow it as I keep going down.
The sinkhole?
The sinkhole, yeah.
Okay. How close are you getting to it?
Not too close that it would be really dangerous. I'll say within like I'll say within 30 feet. I'll say about 30 feet away.
As you begin to approach it, you feel a very slight tug on you in its direction as you get within about 60 feet.
Oh, fuck you. Yeah, I'm not getting drowned. Well, I would love to see where how far you go. I'm not getting dragged to hell today, as I will use a misty step to get out of its range that it's trying to pull me in, and I'll just keep just out of that range.
Okay.
But still following it down.
I'm looking for something.
When it looks like I'm a bit safer, I am disengaging my haste so that I can take that breath without being in a desperate without being in an actual dangerous situation.
Okay. You find a moment to do that. I'm having a bath. So. You continue down. And you... There are no members, fellow members, left around. They have all either been taken or given up. And that heat continues to build in the back of your head. I need you to make me a constitution saving throw.
All right. Fuck.
The heat.
It hurts. It burns.
It hurt. It hurt it in. As it feels like it's burning the connection of your brain to the rest of your body and your capability of thinking.
Well, fuck it.
I need you to know, I rolled a number of dice. 5 of them are ones.
I see.
So you take... 22 points of psychic damage.
Mm-hmm.
And 12 points of fire damage.
All right.
As the pain sears throughout your nervous system.
Shit. Fine. If you're trying to get me out of you, then... I'm sorry to tell you, but I don't pull out easy. If I'm gonna die, then so fucking be it. As I'm going, I am, despite being in pain, I am basically saying fuck it and going down further.
All right. You continue. And other creatures begin to creep into the peripherals of your vision.
Fuck hell. How big are these ones?
The fish you see out of the corner of your vision, based on size is hard to determine. These have to be 40 feet long. You start to see some of the octopi, squid-like creatures. Those easily breaking 80, 100 feet in length.
Well, with how long these fuckers are, I doubt I can outrun them. That doesn't mean I'm not gonna fucking try, as I'm gonna just keep going max speed down and down.
You continue. So one of the squids begin to approach you.
Shit.
At a rapid velocity.
Eve. Can I prepare a spell for when it gets within striking distance of me?
Yeah.
When it looks like it's finally about to strike and grab me, I'm just going to flip it off and be like, "Not today, bitch," as I will Misty Step. Even deeper down.
This creature was hundreds of feet from you, but it approaches you in a mere matter of seconds. And as it lashes out for you, you cast your spell, and you go your 30 feet down. You have seconds before it goes for you again.
Oh, I know that much. Well, what can I fucking do against it? It's gonna keep striking me like...
I'll put it this way. Nothing. You currently have an action before it comes at you again.
Yeah, I know. I had a feeling. Oh. This is fucking dangerous. My plan is fucking dumb as shit. But I have made myself close to the sinkhole on purpose.
Mm-hmm.
As I will action dash and move into the sinkhole's radius to possibly try and averse it from wanting to follow me. Because this is obviously not a normal part of the weave. So I don't know if a weave creature will want to try it.
So you were about 90 feet from the sinkhole after your Misty Step from the feeling you got earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Dashing will get you to 60.
All right, I'll do it then.
Or, sorry, it'll get you 30 feet away from it.
I'll go in. Not in fully, but 30 feet away. It may just be enough to averse this fucker.
You get within 30 feet of it, and as you hit, again, that roughly 60-foot marker, you begin to feel the tug towards it. And it simply grows and grows. As you begin to be pulled into it.
Ah, shit, this was a terrible plan!
The squid can still reach you at the current moment. You are not fully in it yet. But to put the mechanic out straight, it currently has disadvantage. If it happens to hit you and not a clone.
Alright, so I'm at 2 clones currently. So that Correct. Will be an 8 or higher. Fuck. It attacks me.
It's gonna be a dirty 20 to hit.
Fuck. Even with shield, I can't stop it.
Or, hold on, I need to look at something. Give me 2 seconds to make sure I'm doing this correctly.
Okay. Is there anything else I can do? That hit. I don't think I can. I think my
future's over. I'm wrong. It is attempting to grab me.
Mm-hmm.
So, it is going to make an athletics check at disadvantage. I would like you to make me... You can make me an athletics check, or you can make me an acrobatics check at advantage.
Well... It's good that I at least actually have acrobatics. I'll make the acrobatics at advantage.
Alright.
Damn, my rolls are not the best tonight. 15.
It rolled a
have
14.
I rolled above a 10? I've not rolled above a 10 tonight.
Ninja, it rolled a 14.
Woo!
So as this tentacle lashes out at you, you slip by it and enter the sinkhole.
Yep, this is a terrible plan!
I don't know how to describe the feeling you now have. It's not so much the absence of the weed. It's like it was replaced with something else.
An almost like perversion of it.
Something older and powerful.
Oh, this definitely
and
doesn't feel good!
Begin to plummet.
I'm guessing
how fast you're falling.
Yeah. I can't see. I can barely see how fast I'm going.
You see flashes of what you're assuming are more creatures in the distance. As you continue
this
to fall.
Was definitely not a good plan.
And the red glow that occupies the bottom slowly begins to show in the area around, outside.
So did I see the bottom, or do I see the bottom, or not yet?
You don't know.
Oh, fuck. Fuck it. Can I Misty Step out back into 30 feet of it? So that I'm not dragged straight in, so that I'm not dragged who knows how far and straight down in and probably splat.
You can. After we resolve the massive buildup of the heat in the back of your mind.
Oh yeah, that's... Oh, this is gonna fucking hurt.
I would like you to make me a constitution save.
Well, if Roll20 is going to say fuck me, I think... I don't know if I'll make it. I've not rolled above a 10. That was a 2.
Similar to last time, the heat explodes in the back of your head, more powerful this time, as you are deeper and descending rapidly. You take 25 points of psychic damage.
Okay.
And... ...21 points of fire damage.
Alright. Irafis is not looking the best right now. He's just... If he could be coughing up blood because he got hurt, he would be. But he's just like, well, son of a fucking bitch. Well, I've made this choice. I'm staying with it.
In the weave, you're not. In your coffin, you are. As the spectators begin to see the red shine of blood begin to occupy your coffin. But you miss you step out of the hole.
Fuck. That!
And now another thing. As you went from descending at a rapid pace.
Mm-hmm. I got hit with vertigo.
To extreme
it's
resistance.
It's the bins.
Ninja, I now need you to make me a dexterity saving throw.
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest with how my rolls are tonight. I don't know if I'm making it out of this alive. Oh wait, I finally rolled above a 10. Let's go, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh. All right, so you're gonna take half of this.
Mm-hmm.
Why am I doing this? Why don't I just open up this pack right here? Let me grab some dice. You take 6 points of bludgeoning damage.
Ugh. Oh, I God, I never rolled. Let me do that again, me.
So I rolled really low.
Never let me do that again, me. Why did I let myself do that? That was just a bad idea on my part. Next time a giant octopus comes at you, try and think of a clever catchphrase to say, at least before you get shot dragged into a fucking dark sinkhole.
Oh, I should mention, you're 30 feet away. I need another dexterity saving throw.
Well,
you begin to be pulled back into the...
Oh, son of a bitch!
After the equivalent of a round, you are 15 feet from it.
Okay, yeah, I'm using more Misty Steps and my full... I'm gonna Misty Step again to get 45 out from it, and then my full movement to push out as far as I can.
With your movement would be half, but you would still hit the 60-foot marker barely feeling.
Okay. Son of a bitch.
But it is at this point you beat that glow, that red glow, has become more apparent as this moving and shifting red expanse occupies your vision.
So this is it, huh? This is what all the crackpots are talking about? Just a fucking sea of red down here. Well,
it is here.
I came this far.
It is here you begin to notice a handful of more aggressive currents occupying the region. There are two currents near you.
How close near me?
Each one about 45 feet from you.
Do they... Where do these currents jut? Do they go straight down, or...
They seem to curve their way down. It's not at a rapid pace, but spiral their way closer to what you assume
the bottom.
Is the red beach.
Well, that'll be faster, and it won't be as jarring as getting dragged through a sinkhole, at least. As I'll see if I can glide along one of these currents to go further down.
So, these two currents have a very different magical essence from each other. One of them, you feel an essence of power, of the brute usage of Arcana. Can you please make me an Arcana check?
24.
This one reeks of evocation magic.
Evocationers. Violence. Great.
The other one is very different. It is a more protective, deflective type of magic. With that 24 Arcana check, this is abjuration magic.
Well, of any of them, there's one that will cause me less risk of getting blown up, as I will attempt to use the abjuration current to go deeper.
You make your way into this current, and
a lot of my spells are abjuration anyway, so it makes a bit more sense.
There you go. But you enter this current, and it continues to pull you down, not as aggressively as falling, but faster than you were.
It's not as aggressive as getting dragged into a sinkhole of what felt like ancient dark magic.
Yes. continue and you continue until the current begins to peter out towards the edge of this expanse.
Thank you, Abjuration. That was very helpful.
You are now feet away from the red beam.
I've made it this far. If I die, I can at least say in whatever hell I go to that I made that I made it to the bottom. As I touch ground on the red beam,
you begin to approach the red beam. That heat in the back of your head that's been building and building this whole time fades entirely. Do you reach out to touch the red leaf?
All right then. Glad to. What? You happy? What? You? What was that? All just a big test to make sure I made. See if I can make it down here. As he just kind of screams out into the void. Well. If I die, then let people know that I at least made it down here. As I will touch the red weave.
As you go to reach to touch the weave, that abjurative feeling returns as you feel the current of the weave around you change. And you watch as a tentacle whips out and grabs your hand.
So this is how we're fucking playing, huh?
You say that and you turn, expecting some horrifying kraken or something.
Mm-hmm. I'm like fully ready to throw hands with one of those giant octopi.
You can't comprehend what it is you see.
What the fuck?
You see massive form. The tentacles that had lashed out at you forming and morphing into something else that through a range of things. You cannot see the a specific central mass.
It's just ever changing, ever morphing.
Correct.
What in the fuck are you? Last time I checked, I was told there weren't any little things like that down, like that, like you in the weave.
Speak towards this being. And you feel the connection join as it reaches out and connects with you.
Oh, that feels weird.
Might I ask what you are doing here?
Well, it's a trial by the group that I'm part in to go to try and push yourself as far as you can through the weave. So, that's what I've done. I pushed myself all the way here to the bottom, and I'm barely functioning for it. If I was gonna die, I'm at least making sure that I'll be able to have a cool story to tell in hell.
Remember who? You are interesting. You are different. Why did you join the Weave?
multiple reasons.
They said they helped me fix a problem of me being stuck in a bit of a loop for a few months. And they promised to help me unlock more of my potential as a bladesinger, which they have.
Interesting. Do you know what I am?
No, I do not.
Young one, there are many forces in the world. I am one that guards one of the branches of magic.
Guardian of a whole branch of magic, huh? Gotta say, didn't expect to meet something like that today.
It's not often we get people this close to the weed that are hesitant enough for us to intervene.
I see.
The last one is standing not too far from you as you turn and you see that sinkhole connected to the weave below you.
So that fucking sinkhole that dragged me down here was... It's another one of people like me who got this far?
They are a special case.
Great. Well, if you don't mind me asking, what branch of magic do you govern?
I embody the magic of abjuration.
Well, thanks to the abjuration magic is how I got down here, so I guess I have to thank you for that. And keeping me alive. A lot of things, actually.
I see potential.
Potential?
I need you to promise me something.
Luckily my mother never told me to make a deal with an eldritch being that with a form I can't conceive. So I guess that means I can't. So I'm down for it. Besides, you probably know this stuff better than me, so I can question it.
I'm going to give you something. A focus we hand out when we please. But do not attempt to reach the Red Weave again until you are truly ready.
If I may ask, how do I know when I'm ready?
You'll know.
I fucking knew you would say that. May I at least get a name of you, my gracious abjurative savior?
Ethan looks at notes. I am simply referred to as the Guardian of Abjuration.
All right, a bit of a mouthful, but I'll deal with it.
Do we have an accord?
Yeah, I think we do.
You watch as a hand forms, and it reaches out and puts a finger to your forehead. And you don't see anything happen, but you feel something occupy the coffin your body is currently in.
Oh, that feels off.
Now, return to the surface. Tell them what you saw. And then we will go from there.
Well, do you have an express way out?
He just chuckles. And you see a small flash of energy as you begin to rocket towards the surface.
This was not what I planned!
You don't suffer any injury as a master of abjuration just sent you up.
Thankfully. Thank you, protective magic, I guess.
You look around, you see the creatures flashing by, obviously in the opposite direction this time. Instead of it getting bigger, they're getting smaller.
The moment I pass that one octopus that tried to eat me earlier, I'm going to flip it off. Just to spite it. I won, bitch.
You fly by it. You get your own mental victory from it.
Good. It probably doesn't even understand me flipping it off, but I don't care. I won.
In all honesty, it didn't see you. You're moving too fast.
Irafis doesn't care. He won. He won in the end.
You ascend that sinkhole near you. As you near the surface, you see the other indention. Has shifted its position.
Seemingly he will look
near where you started.
I see. He will look to the sinkhole and just be like, well, I'm gonna just have to figure out who you are, and who knows, maybe you'll at least give me a good... Maybe you'll be the one to give me the fight that I've always wanted.
As you continue, you get maybe 100 feet from the surface, and the force that's pulling you up flickers out. It flickers out. It doesn't feel intentional.
I see. Well, I'm just gonna call you Abjur for now, but thank you. As I will finish the rest of the journey myself.
You yourself begin to move, wondering why and how the force was seemingly dispelled off of you. And you look around, taking in your surroundings. No other members occupying the weave with you at the moment. And you begin to notice something approaching. Not...
Oh, son of a bitch.
Not a creature. You look off in one direction and see a disturbance. I just want to say a disturbance in the force, because that's all that popped in the head. You see a disturbance in the weave approaching.
Oh, damn it.
You see the weave itself jumping and twisting and bending and speeding up and reversing.
Fuck you, I ain't dying today.
It is something in the waking world disturbing the surface of the weave.
Oh. Well, I guess I have my own mission. Well, I guess I have my own thing to start figuring out. What the fuck is causing that? He will look at it for a moment. and just mentally register, all right, as probably a thank you to the Guardian, I'm gonna have to definitely figure out what the fuck's causing that. As he will finish his swim, he will continue his swim to the surface.
You make your way to the surface, and you exit the weed, thrust back into the ice-cold waters of the coffin. Unable to currently breathe, and the water tinted red around you, with your own blood.
Irafis just mentally is like, well, fuck. That was certainly an experience. I can't say anything. I can't breathe. But that's certainly an experience.
The lid begins to be removed from your coffin. And as you're moving, waiting, you feel something in the coffin with you, some object.
Can I grab a hold of this object?
Yes, you can. This is seemingly a book.
I don't remember dragging my book in here. Whatever. Figure it out later. Figure it out later, me.
But you are removed from the coffin.
God. Fuck breathing fresh air is good. There's nothing to breathe down there, you know.
You sit there and you're sitting there, you're coughing, recovering from what you just
Your lungs are full of ice water.
Your lungs are full of ice water and blood.
Oh, I never thought that I'd have to cough of my own blood from inside my lungs. But, well, I guess there's first time for everything now, isn't there?
You didn't look in front of you. As you lock eyes with the Sorcerer Supreme, who is now standing directly in front of you.
Well, hey there.
What happened to you down there?
Oh, a lot of things. But if you want the important stuff, got to the bottom. Tried to touch the thing. Tried to touch the weave. Got arm grabbed by a tentacle. Met apparently the Guardian of Abjuration. And now I'm back.
You met a Guardian.
Yep. I thought I was going to have to fight another... I thought I was about to have to fist fight a squid, but well... But it was luckily just something that I physically could not comprehend with my mind.
So they do exist. Interesting. I'm going to report this to the Weave Master. I would like you to follow the weavers out. They will prepare you. I want you on a mission with me in a week's time.
All right, that's certainly a way to wake myself up after not dying. If I didn't know any better, I'd say you're fucking with me. But I have a good feeling that you're not. So, aye, boss.
I assure you, I am not. You and a handful of others will accompany me to the spring festival that the city is holding, as the Midnight Suns plan to do something. They attacked one of our bases for it. And we mean to stop them if we can.
Alright. Sounds good to me. Oy vey.
There will be many people around.
Well, luckily, I'm a master of discretion. I say, completely not being a master of discretion.
The urge to just say civilian casualties are not encouraged, they're required.
Well, that'd be a problem in one instance, but... And knock some fools out, slash the less cooperative ones, and make sure they're not dead. It's fine. Gotcha.
He turns to address the room. That is enough diving for the day. I'm going to make my report. Have fun. And he turns to exit the room.
All right, then. I will, as I am getting out, I am going to pull out this book that seemingly has gotten into my coffin.
Okay. You pull out this book. It is a dark brown leather-bound tome with various arcane insignia and runes across it. I do have an image for this.
Alright, let me look at this. Now, how the fuck did you get in there with me? Was that you? Was this you, Abjur? Did you shove a book up there with me? I did.
He
feel
shoved
that
a book
like
up your ass.
He shoved a book up my ass. Fucking god! Come on! Oy vey. I need to hold my sword again to feel better. I felt naked without it.
As you're standing there, I would like you to make me your choice of an arcana or a perception check.
One of them is higher than the other.
I would assume so, and I'm assuming it's arcana.
You're that correct.
That disturbance that you felt, or you saw on your way up, even outside the weed, you feel it.
That does not feel nice.
Pierce, from how you would be facing, assumably now, would appear to be coming from your right.
Well, I turn to the right, obviously. Okay. Turn and look over there.
You see the satyr figure you saw earlier, conversing with another hooded figure. Can't make out many details, you see. But he's wearing red leather, adorned in silver gauntlets.
Me and you are going to have a conversation, I guess.
He goes to put his arm around the satyr as they walk out of the room. And as another member passes your vision, there's seemingly just another member of the Weave walking with this figure. And you don't feel the disturbance.
I guess I gotta find you. I guess I'll have to find you again, because I need fucking answers. It's the least I can do for Abjur. As he will finally, like, shake himself off and just be like, well, sorry that I kind of messed all this shit up, but hey. As he will go over to where he was instructed to exit with the weavers.
One of the clerics are going to stop you and slap you with some healing magic.
Fair! Thank you! I only just noticed!
You're just gonna end up at max. However many casts it takes, they're giving it to you.
I can help too. I can cast Cure Wounds a little bit. But thanks!
The cleric that's touching you just puts a finger to your lips.
be quiet.
Archer!
But you are allowed to leave.
Do not question my healing methods.
Do not question my healing methods. Bro, wear your pants.
I deemed them unnecessary.
He will just like crack his Irafis will just like crack his neck, make sure that all that nothing feels like it has completely shattered, and he's gonna be like, "Oh, thank God."
Nothing feels shattered, okay. But you have a terrible headache.
I'm gonna need a nap later.
You have a migraine that makes migraines shit themselves.
I'm gonna need a fucking nap. I'm gonna really need one. Thank you. As he'll just give a thank you to the cleric who fixed him up as he continues on his way.
You limp your way back to the Hall of Doorways.
Ugh.
And you insert your key into one of the holes. Make your way into
sleep. This place.
And as rest takes you, and you wonder what is happening in a week, that is where we're going to end your session zero.
Can I, before we end it quickly, can I look through this book that I have seemingly gotten from the Guardian of Abjuration before I pass the fuck out?
Before passing out, you cannot understand it currently.
Oh, well, fucking beautiful. This is just gibberish.
When you wake up, you will, and I will. Which means when we're as we end, I will reveal this to you in the roll 20.
Gotcha. I just love the thought that it's like, damn. Either I'm dumb or this just is all squiggles. This one just looks like a straight up bird.